Hello guys, welcome to English Camp, your ultimate destination to learn this beautiful language effectively. Today, we have picked up a very interesting topic for you guys. You know, what's the difference between gone to a place and been to a place? Gone to a place and been to a place. Suppose, I take an example, I have been to Puri, my father has gone to Kottak. Is there any difference? So this is basically comes under high school grammar. So let's start from the beginning. Actually, we have to find it out where this gone and been come from. Look at here. Here we know this is the base form of the verb, and this is the past simple form, and this is past participle. So every verb, whether it is regular or irregular, you have three forms. That is go, went, gone. Like that, there is another verb called be. And the past simple is was and were, and the past participle form is been. So take another verb like break, broke, and broken. So now find out what is past participle. Past participle like exactly used as an adjective. Just look at the sentence, guys. Hey, you are about to fall down. You are sitting in a broken chair. Suppose your friend is sitting in a very broken chair and you are trying to, you know, warn him not to sit there, otherwise he will fall down. So look at the sentence. Hey, you are about to fall down. You are sitting in a broken chair. So look at the underlying word, broken. This is that we have taken past participle form of break verb. So here it is used as, this past participle form is used as an adjective. And this past participle form is also used especially in perfect forms. What are the perfect forms? We have present perfect, we have past perfect, and we have future perfect. So I have taken an example here. I have taken breakfast. This means present breakfast. So this is present perfect. I have taken my breakfast. It is present perfect. So what is the perfect tense? Perfect tense is that, suppose this is the timeline. Just check it out. This is the timeline. That means this is now, that means whatever, suppose I am in giving some lecture, that means I am doing it right away, okay? And this is the past time and this is the future time. Suppose if an action has been started in the past and completed in the past, then we can say it is, but effect is there. This is called the perfect, an example of a present perfect tense. Right now, we are trying to use all these things in this sentence. Look at the sentence here. I have been to Puri and my father has gone to Puri. So what's the difference? Look at here. Suppose your starting point is home, okay? This is your starting point. And this is Puri, your destination, okay? So the moment you say, I have been to Puri, that means you visited Puri and returned. You visited Puri and returned. So this shows it is a completed action. That means I have been to Puri. What does it imply? That means I have already visited Puri and returned. That means it's a completed, I mean loop. The loop has been completed. You visited some place and come back. Return. Whenever you say like that, so you have to use the word been. So take another example. Like my father has gone to Puri. What that means? Starting point is, suppose this is your starting point, your home. Okay. And your destination is Kottak. So the moment you say that, means visit part is there. I visited Puri, but no mention of return. So whenever, suppose I'll ask you, hey, where is your father? You can say, my father has gone to Kottak. That means you want to tell me, or you are trying to give an example that your father has gone to Kottak. That means he visited Kottak. So far he has not returned. So I believe there is a big difference between been and gone. So I have given all the things. So this way it will continue, and I believe we enjoyed this video. Okay, so we'll try to find more interesting videos like this, which will help you in your competitive and all class examinations. All the best, happy learning, keep sharing.